So I'd like to do a short video showing you how to calculate confidence intervals of various types in Minitab 19. So to start with, we have the data. It's a complicated set of data. We've got various pieces of information. We've got some categorical variables we can do proportions on. We've got several numerical variables. And so what we're going to do is we're going to do a one sample confidence interval for one mean. We're going to do a confidence interval for proportions, for one proportion. We're going to do two means, and we're going to do two proportions. And the two mean sample comes in two different flavors. So we have an option over here on our second workbook to do paired data. But we're going to start out with the unpaired data. So to do a one sample confidence interval, we're going to go to basic statistics under stat, and we see these various types of options here. I'm going to skip the one sample Z because this is a somewhat unusual situation. So we're going to start with a one sample t-test. Now hypothesis tests are done basically the same way, so everything I say here will apply to hypothesis testing later on. We have one or more samples each in a column, and we have the option of doing summarized data. This is the raw data, so we're going to select the default. And when we click on our box for our options, it's going to give us the categories, the columns that have numerical data in them. And so I'm just going to do salary, select. And to start off, I'm just going to select OK. Now you can select some of these other options, but for right now. And so what it's going to do for us is it's going to calculate our confidence interval for salary. All right, so that's one sample confidence interval for means, mean of salary. It gives us all the information that we would need to calculate this by hand, but it conveniently calculates the interval for us. So now what I'd like to do is I would like to do a proportion problem. So we're going to use one of the categorical variables. So I'm also going to go to stat, and I'm going to do down here one proportion. One or more samples each in a column, summarize data. So this is the default. We're going to select here. And so now we're going to select, let's do gender. Select. And then again, we have options that we can choose. We can change the confidence level. Maybe I want to do a 90% confidence level. The default is always 95, but I can change this if I need to. These things generally only apply for hypothesis testing. And so select OK. And so now it is going to actually tell us what it's calculating. Typically it will choose whatever is first in the column as the proportion. So if you need to shuffle this around to maybe get the female one, since there's only two options, male or female, you can always calculate the confidence interval for female from the confidence interval for males by doing a complement. But in this case, the confidence interval for males is this, and again, it gives us information, it gives us the count, it gives us the total number of data in the sample, it gives us the sample proportion, and then it calculates the confidence interval for us. Okay, so those are the one sample ones. So now, let's try to do a two sample one. Two sample T. So this assuming that both of the data that we're looking at is independent, so that they don't have any relationship to each other, and in fact they can be different counts. The samples are all in one column. We could have samples in two columns, so they're pre-separated, or we can enter summarized data. We have all the samples in one column, so the samples, let's do age. That's the numerical value. And then the sample IDs, that's going to tell us how are we splitting the into the two samples. And so this has to be categorical, or should be categorical, and it should have only two values because it's a two sample question. So I'm going to pick PC job, since that's a yes or no. And again, you can select options. You can also select graphs. Maybe you want to look at a box plot. 95%, maybe we'll make it 99% just for fun. And again, these are more for, these two options are more for hypothesis testing, so I'm going to ignore those. Now the issue of assume equal variances, there's two different ways to calculate confidence intervals when you're doing two sample t-tests. You can assume the variances are equal, and there's a formula for that, which is not terribly complicated, or you can assume the variances are not equal. You don't assume that the variances are equal. Because the unequal variance assumption assumes less, actually, because you're not making any assumption at all about the variances. They might be equal, they might not be equal. That is usually considered better. If you're calculating it by hand, it's terrible. But we have technology, so I'm going to leave this assume equal variances unchecked. If you really want to assume equal variances, you can, of course, then check this box. But we're going to go with the more general, broader assumption that the variances are, in fact, not necessarily equal. And so hit OK. And then finally, OK. And so again, we have our two categories, our assumed mean difference. This is important when it comes to the sign of our value. We have our descriptive statistics calculated here, and then the confidence interval. The mean difference is calculated here, and then this is the confidence interval. Now you'll notice that for this confidence interval, the bounds, one is negative, one is positive. That means that it contains zero, and therefore this is not statistically meaningful distinction between the two categories. And then, of course, later on, we'll come back to our test information. And finally, we have our box plot. And notice that what they've done is they've plotted the means on our two box plots to give us some idea of a sort of a visual reference for what our test is implying. And this line between them is not very steep, which suggests that they're not that different. And then finally, we want to do two proportions. So let's go back to stat, basic statistics, two proportions. Both samples are in one column. Each sample is in its own column. And summarize data. So the samples, we want to pick two categorical variables because this is a proportion question. So let's pick gender as the samples, select. And then sample IDs, we want to define the two categories by whether they've worked a PC job before or not. And again, well, I'm going to use the 95% confidence interval difference. And then we have test methods, estimate the proportion separately, or use the pooled estimate. Estimating the proportion separately is a better default, and that is the default here, so we're just going to accept it. And then hit OK. And so what we find out, again, is it calculates our confidence interval for us. And the event is gender male, and it's comparing gender male where the PC job is no and gender male where the PC job is yes. And in this case, where men had, in this sample, had no occurrence or very few occurrences, no occurrences of actually having a previous PC job. And so the confidence interval here is basically the confidence interval for the one sample. That will obviously not always be the case. And then if you want to specifically do female, the best thing to do would be to actually separate the data into separate columns, sort by gender, and pull the female data out. And then the last thing that we wanted to do was the paired data. Now for paired t-test data, you have to have exactly the same number of values in each of your two categories, and they need to be matched in some way. The information provided to you needs to indicate that they have been paired or matched in some fashion. So now we're going to go to paired data, stat, basic statistics, paired T. Each sample is a column, that is the default, or you can put in summarized data for the differences. Sample 1, we're going to put in female salary, and sample 2, we're going to put in male salary. You will not get the right answer. In fact, this may not even work if you have different numbers of data. In fact, it shouldn't work. And again, we're going to look at options, and I'm just going to go with the defaults because we want a 95% confidence interval. And then select OK. And so again, what it's done here is it's calculated the differences between these salaries, and then it's calculated the mean, and it's essentially calculated a one sample confidence interval on the differences. So we didn't have to do any of that work. All of that work has been done for us, and we have our confidence interval reported here.